President Obama wants America to take the giant leap to Mars.
As our Greg Argos tells us from the Einstein Healthcare Science Center, it's no easy task.
The president announcing a very ambitious goal to send humans to Mars and back safely to Earth by the 2030s. And though this is at least 14 years away, experts say it's entirely possible.
It would go in stages. We'd launch all the materials that we need to establish a base, a landing base on Mars. Blast off from Earth, spend some time in Earth orbit, and then head from Earth orbit out for that long trip to Mars.
It may sound simple, but getting a man to Mars and back safely is a multi-billion dollar project. And the deadline to accomplish this has now been set by President Obama.
I think it's a great thing that he shows continued support for NASA's primary mission.
In an op-ed, the president says he wants NASA to team with private sector companies to accomplish the Man on Mars mission by the 2030s. Speaking with us via Skype at the Franklin Institute, Chief Astronomer Derrick Pitts says this is one deadline that can be met.
What's definitely possible to do in the next, in less than two decades, there's no question about that. You know, some of the technology is there, some of the infrastructure already exists.
But he says there is one big question that needs to be answered with a yes. If getting a human on Mars will be something not only seen in the movies.
Do we as a nation have the will to want to do this? And will we authorize Congress to sign into law a bill that states that this work is going to continue no matter how the presidency changes?
Now, Pitts points out we were able to send a man to the moon within 8 years of President Kennedy's speech, and that was in the 1960s with much less advanced technology. In the Einstein Healthcare Science Center, I'm Greg Argos.